So I'm starting the kingpin job now. Hopefully it'll go pretty smooth. I'm going to speed up the camera because I don't think you really need to see every bolt being unscrewed, and you get the basic idea of it. It's, pretty basic what has to come off to get the kingpin out.
So that wasn't bad at all. Got it out pretty easy, actually. I guess now it's time to clean it up. Okay, so it's a beautiful day out here. So I'm out here at my makeshift workbench. Got a picnic table out here. It's been out here for about 25 years, and I think we only ate once, and that was years ago. Since then, it's been a workbench. So I'm going to try to knock these bushings out. Let's see. I'm just using a socket and a claw hammer. There she goes. One out. Now the other one's going to be a little bit harder because this one sticks out the bottom, so I'm going to have to go in from in between them. These are old tools. I wouldn't use my good stuff for this. Square hit. Yep, that's not bad. And clean in there. All right, I'll be back in a few minutes. I'm gonna go clean up these holes, get them ready for the new bushings. Okay, and when the bushings go in, the top bushing fits all the way in the slot, but the bottom one, it has to hang out the bottom. It's got to be even inside here, so it's got to go past it to the bottom, which is easy. Going to try to press it in with the vise. First of all, let me get it started. Now, you don't want to hammer these in, but to get it started, line up the grease fitting with the hole in the bushing. Just a few light taps. Then we'll open up our press. Making sure, oh, it's a little crooked. Let's straighten it out here. Okay, that's straight. Grease fittings lined up. Press is open far enough. Let's go this way. Get it so it's flat on your jaws and as much meat on this end as you can if your jaws are too small. Okay, that's going in pretty easy. There we go. I'm gonna take another little bite here because left it up a little bit. Let's try it this way. There, that pushed it all the way in. Looky there, and I didn't even screw it up. Okay, now for the bottom one. Oh, by the way, I cleaned those holes up. I just cleaned them out real good with some degreaser and a little bit of very fine sandpaper around the hole to make sure there was nothing stuck in there, but they were pretty clean. So, kill our dog over there. So this one we're gonna have to put up on the top. Same thing. Line up the grease fitting. Started. Let's check and make sure it's straight. You have to look at it. The hole is on a little bit of an angle, so you have to kind of look at it, make sure it's straight with the hole. Looks good. Open up the press. Try to get as much on there as you can. It just barely fits my jaws. There we go. Now this one, it's gonna bottom out. You'll still see some sticking out here. It's flush with this, some sticking out on the bottom. It's just the way the old ones were, because it has to fit here. A little bit of extra right at the bottom. There, done. Now comes the real fun, reaming the bushings. Let me go get my reamer and my oil. I'll be right back. Okay, so let's let the reaming begin. I don't have cutting oil, so I'm using what I got. I don't think it much matters as long as there's oil on it. The end of this reamer is a 5/8 or a 3/4 inch 12 point. Now to get it started, you gotta make it look like it's straight. Once it starts, it'll find the center. But in the beginning, you gotta kind of hold it in place. It started already. A little downward pressure. You'll feel it cutting. Throw a little more oil on it. I'm gonna pull it out and clean it, because you gotta take them out often and clean the shavings off of it. I'm not pushing from the top, I'm holding onto it here and gripping it to push it down. No. now that I'm in a little ways, I'm going to switch this out and put my ratchet on it because I just find it a little easier. Never turn it backwards. Never turn it backwards. Now I'm going to pull it out to clean the end off. And I'm still going to continue to turn clockwise. Never turn it backwards because it dulls your... It will dull your reamer. Plus, I think it grinds all the shavings up inside of it too. In the bushing. So I'm about halfway through that one already. Let's throw some more oil in it. You really can't use too much oil. Just use your top hand to steady it in place so you're not pulling against it. I got a long ways to go here. Oil on here, a little more on here. Little oil everywhere. Gets a little harder now because you got the teeth cutting here and you got them cutting on the top. So you're cutting two at the same time at this point. Takes a little more pressure too. When you get to this point, because you're cutting too. There, now I feel it cutting. I'm actually pushing from the top because I wasn't getting enough pressure. Okay, the bottom of the reamer made it through the bottom. I'm gonna pull it back out and clean it up again. See what's on there? You don't really want to be grinding all that in there. Maybe I should have pulled it out sooner. So, now that you made it through, clean it up real good again. Get all the shavings off of here that fell on it. Clean that hole. It's weird. Clean that hole, and we're gonna put it back in. Just gonna run it easy. and I run it just real easy through it just to clean it all up good. Not even really pushing, I'm just letting the weight of the reamer run it. Okay. Let's pull it back up. Clean it off again. I doubt there's anything in that hole. Nope. Just letting the weight of the reamer do it. Oop, there we go. Feels like it's cutting something right now, a little bit, not much. Yep, there's a little bit on there that time. It was cutting something, so I'm gonna do it again. I can turn that through there with my hand and no wrench, I'm gonna call that good. Clean my reamer off, leaving some of that nice oil on there. Put it away for the next time, which there probably won't be a next time. Now I'm gonna clean the hole out. I ran out of everything I had. I'm using intake cleaner, but that should cut through it anyway. That'll cut through that oil. Using a clean rag so I don't put any shavings in there from my other one. Test it out. Yeah, if you're doing these, don't mix them up because there is a right and a left kingpin. Ah, look at that. Beautiful. No play. It's perfect. Let's see, that would go this way. This is the right side of the car. I almost wasn't gonna do this one because it had just a slight bit of wear on it, but that's kind of crazy not to when you got the whole set, you got the thing apart already. Anyway, there you go. That's installing kingpin bushings and reaming them. Anyway, there you go. That's driving the old bushings out, putting the new ones in, reaming them out. Beautiful fit. Okay, we're ready to clean these up and put them in. First thing I want to do is run some grease through these fittings to clean out any metal shavings in there. Okay. Now, I don't have the spindle arm in it, so it's not going to go through into this hole. I'm going to have to clean that out with a Q-tip or something. But I got this one here. I don't know whether you can see all the shavings in the end of it. There's quite a few in there. So let's wipe that out. Really, nothing came out of this one because that was past where the cutting was going on. But let's see if I can poke this Q-tip through there. Oh yeah. But I might have to bend it a little bit. Yep. Now, I'm just going to pull it all the way through. Can you see what's on the end of that? They're on there. Let's see. Yep. I don't even have the spindle arms to put them in because I have new ones coming. And I wanted to get this going. Let's see what we got here. Nope, nothing left there. But I think that's good. A lot came out on that first one, but after that, I'm not seeing anything. I think I got it all. So I just put part of it together. I didn't put the pieces in the bottom yet. I just tapped that in just a little bit to tighten it up to make sure everything is looking right. And it is. This is right up on the bearing. So I think I'm going to take it apart and put it back together the right way with all the other pieces in the bottom. Looks like it's going to line up. I did use two really thin spacers on here. I don't even think I needed them. Might not have needed both of them. And I packed the bearing good with grease. Put a little grease in the bushings, a little on the kingpin, and here we go. Come on. There we go. Now, felt part under here. Oof. I guess maybe that has to go on there first. How am I gonna get that in here? Alright, we're gonna go at this a different way. So I stuck the old kingpin up through the bottom to hold that on. And hopefully. There we go. It. I did clean that old king pin up real good before I stuck it in there. All right, let's see. Now it says you have to put the brake actuator in before you tighten it, but I don't know whether you really do or not, because it seems like it goes in anyway, even when the kingpin is in place. But we'll do it the way they say. Okay, let's see if my hole is lined up. Seems perfect. There we go. I'm going to take the lock washer off for a minute. Just to bottom this out and see if it's going any further when I hammer it. A little bit. A little bit. Oh, yeah. I'm just putting a nut bottoming out on the axle and to see if it's moving in when I'm hammering it. When it stops moving, then I'll take the nut off and put the lock washer on. There we go. Last two times it didn't move, so that's gonna be it. Well, it feels good. And when I pull up on it, that top bearing won't turn. There's plenty of space in there. And I did something I hadn't planned on doing. I was going to leave this car pretty much the way it was, not cleaning anything up, leaving it greasy, grimy underneath. But after I had it apart, I couldn't do it. So I painted just the end here. After I get the car outside, I'll do the rest of it. I got the backing plates over there drying now. And I really can't go any further with this because I'm waiting for the tie rod balls. So I got a lot of cleaning up to do.
But I think it's good to go. So now I'm on to something else. Hope you got something out of this video, or at least it was entertaining. I'll be into the brakes. That'll be another whole video.